Okay, let's see if I have better luck this time getting a better image of the Super Sniper 5x20 x50mm. This is the latest and greatest and probably one of the best value for your FFP buck. So, like the Trigger contest, I'm aiming at that pine tree that's about 130 yards away. Let me do a focus to make sure that we get the best image possible. Adjust the parallax. Not a big deal at 100 at 5x, but it will be as we gradually zoom in. Okay, so you can see the reticle of the Super Sniper. Right now I have it set on auto. So that way the camera is going to determine the iris size. So here we have it at 5x, and I'm going to move the magnification to 6x. So we're gradually zooming in, 6x, at the pine tree. Now let's go to 7x. So it still looks pretty bright and clear for now. Let's go to 8x. And power ring goes marks it from 8x to 10x, so halfway in between. This should be 9x magnification. This should be 10x magnification. So here's the magnification that a lot of the US military snipers used to shoot at. And that's what the FFP reticle looks like. You can see it's, it looks like it's gradually growing bigger and bigger. Twelve x 14x. One thing you'll notice is that at this higher magnification we're beginning to get some vignetting at the sides. What that tells me is the eye relief is changing a little bit. That's usually what causes this. Okay, I tweaked the scope a little bit to reduce that little edge, upper edge vignetting. Now let's continue with the magnification test. Now let's go to 16x. And finally, let's go all the way to 20. So this is full mag and you can still see some vignetting. Let me see if I can adjust the scope, the camera position again to get rid of it. Okay, I'm supporting the digiscoping unit a little bit to try to get rid of the upper edge vignetting. So this is what it looks like if I try to hold it very carefully with my hand. Okay.